so we'd like to show you some step-by-step idle drop procedures for each type of Honda engine. We've grouped the bikes by carburetor categories: single carburetor, twin carburetors, four carburetors, and the six carburetor CBX. Let's look first at models with a single carburetor. Here we're talking about bikes like the XL series, the CB125S, the CM185T and 200T, the CT70, 90 and 110, and the C70. On all these bikes, the procedure for adjusting idle drop is the same. Only the specifications of how far to turn the pilot screw will vary. Remember, before you begin the idle drop procedure, it's critical that you perform the preliminary checks and preparation steps that we discussed in the basic procedure. We'll use this XL250S to demonstrate the idle drop procedure for single-cylinder motorcycles. Okay, the single carburetor engine is the easiest to adjust. Just slowly turn the pilot screw in, clockwise, until the engine stops. The fuel mixture has been leaned out to the point of causing misfire, and the engine stalls. Next, turn the screw out, or counterclockwise, the amount specified in the applicable shop manual. Here on this XL250S, the manual says to back the screw out one turn. Now start the engine and check the idle speed. If necessary, readjust it to spec. And if the bike runs rough, repeat the procedure. That's all there is to it. Now just cement on the limiter cap to prevent any counterclockwise rotation of the pilot screw, and you're done. Why, on our XL250S test bike, the whole idle mixture adjustment procedure took only a few minutes. Next, let's look at the idle drop procedure for models with two carburetors. You'll use this procedure on the Hawks and the CX500. We'll use a CB400T for our example here. Here again, you must perform the basic checks and preparation steps. And for these dual carburetor models, you must synchronize the carbs. Adjust each pilot screw, in or out, to obtain the highest engine speed possible. Adjust each pilot screw individually, and watch your tack. Next, reset the idle to specification. On this CB400T, we set the idle at 1200 RPM, per the service manual spec. Now slowly turn one pilot screw in until engine speed drops 100 RPM. Our CB400T took 3/4 of a turn in to give a 100 RPM idle drop, so don't expect RPM to fall immediately. All right, now back the screw out as specified in the shop manual. The 1980 CB400T manual calls for 3/8 of a turn out. Next, readjust the idle speed, and then slowly turn in the other pilot screw until the engine speed drops 100 RPM. When the 100 RPM drop is reached, back the pilot screw out to specification, just like the first adjustment. Okay, adjust the idle speed again. Cement the limiter caps into correct position, and you're done. Incidentally, the GL1000 is adjusted just like the twin carburetor bikes, not like other four-cylinder bikes or the 1980 GL1100. Just refer to the shop manual. It'll set you straight. Okay, now let's look at Hondas with four carburetors. These bikes include the CB650, CB750s, and the new CB900 and GL1100. We'll use a CB900 for our test bike in this section. Now, before you start the idle drop procedure, again remember to make all your preliminary checks and preparation steps. To start with, turn all four pilot screws out one half turn from the initial setting you made when the carburetors were still on the bench. If idle speed increases by 50 RPM or more, turn each pilot screw out an additional one half turn. Continue this process until engine RPM changes less than 50 RPM when all four pilot screws are turned out one half turn each. This may take several passes. One word of caution. Be sure you turn each pilot screw equally. It's easy to get confused with repetitive steps, so work from the number one cylinder to the number four. You'll always know where you are that way. Okay, when the idle changes less than 50 RPM, readjust the idle speed to specification. Next, slowly turn the number one pilot screw in until engine speed drops 50 RPM. On our test CB900, it took several turns to get the 50 RPM drop. So be patient. Turn the screw slowly and watch that tachometer. Now, just as with the singles and twins, turn the pilot screw out the specified amount to its final position. The CB900 manual calls for one turn out. Then readjust the idle speed to factory specs. On to the number two carburetor pilot screw now. Turn it in until the 50 RPM drop is reached. Then out to the manual specification. And then reset the idle to spec. Repeat the exact same steps for the number three carburetor. And again for the number four carburetor. Carefully install the limiter caps to prevent any enrichment adjustment. And that does it. Now that bike will perform the way it was intended to, and you're going to have another happy customer. Okay, let's take a look at the CBX. With six carburetors, it can get a little tricky, so pay close attention. First off, don't forget all the preliminaries. Save yourself some time and make sure the checks and preparation steps are right to start with. On the CBX, adjust each pilot screw in or out to get the highest possible engine RPM. Remember, adjust each pilot screw individually. You won't turn all of them the same amount. Now go ahead and reset the idle speed to 900 RPM per the service manual. Then count the number of turns required to lightly seat the number one carburetor pilot screw. Be careful you don't tighten it too tight, because you could damage the pilot screw seat. Write down exactly the number of turns that it took to seat the number one pilot screw, right down to the fraction of a turn. Now you'll leave the number one pilot screw turned in while you adjust carburetors 2 through 6. That's because the six cylinder runs so smoothly that idle drop would be inaccurate otherwise. Next, slowly turn the number two pilot screw in until engine speed drops 50 RPM. Turn the pilot screw out exactly one half turn from the point the 50 RPM drop was obtained. Now these last two steps are repeated for the number 3, 4, 5, and 6 carburetors. Turn the pilot screw in until engine speed drops 50 RPM, and then out one half turn from that point. Okay, now back out the number 1 pilot screw, the number of turns you recorded earlier. It should now be back at its original position. Next, turn the number 6 pilot screw in until it seats lightly, and again record the number of turns. Now you perform the idle drop adjustment again, but in the opposite direction. You start with carburetor number 5 and work your way down to number 1. And the adjustment is the same as before. Turn the pilot screw in until engine speed drops 50 RPM and back it out one half turn. When all the carbs are adjusted, simply turn the number 6 pilot screw out the exact number of turns recorded earlier. Then reset the idle speed to 900 RPM. Cement on those permanent limiter caps, and you're done with the idle drop procedure on the CBX. Well, this program has covered quite a bit of ground, from theory to step-by-step procedures. But do keep in mind that all these procedures are contained in your Honda shop manuals, so don't hesitate to use them for reference. And there's one other thought I'd like to leave you with. Now, the idle drop procedure is not really all that tough. Just a little time and patience, that kind of stuff. And it's one of the best ways, at least as far as we know, for keeping performance real high and emissions way low. So if you'll follow this program and use your shop manual too, ain't no one gonna do idle drop better than you. And thanks for watching.